Hello students, in today's biology class you will learn about pollination. So let's see what is pollination. Pollination is the transfer of pollen grains from a male part that is called as anther to a female part that is called as stigma of a plant. Due to the transfer of pollen grains from male to female part, fertilization occur, and as a result of fertilization, seeds are being produced. This pollination process is mostly done by animals or by wind, and the animals or wind, these are called as pollinating agents. And the animals which are included in this transfer of pollen grains process, such as insects, birds, bat, water, wind, and even plants do this process themselves. Now the next is the types of pollination. Two types of pollination is there. First one, self-pollination. Second, cross-pollination. In this picture you can see self-pollination means transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma within the same flower. As you can see in this picture, first picture, the process occurs in a same flower. Next is cross-pollination. Cross-pollination, in this the transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma occurs in between two different flowers of same species. You can see in the given picture, both the flowers are same, and the transfer of pollen grains occur from anther to stigma. This transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma within two different flowers of the same species is called as cross-pollination. Now see in details about self and cross-pollination. Self-pollination is the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to stigma of the same flower or another flower of the same plant. As you can see, in the first flower you can see the transfer of pollen grains occur within the same flower, and in the second one the transfer of pollen grains occur in two different flowers of the same plant. Now the next is cross-pollination. Cross-pollination is the transfer of pollen grains from the anther of one flower to the stigma of a genetically different flower. Cross-pollination is performed with the help of an external agency. As you can see here, in cross-pollination, the two different flowers are there, but they will be of same species, but genetically different flowers means this transfer occurs between from male flower to female flower occurs. And cross-pollination is also called as xenogamy or allogamy. Next, in this cross-pollination it is done by different agents, and these agents are insects, wind and water. Now first see insect pollination. As you know, the male part, that is pollen grains, and the female part, that is stigma, both can be present in two different plants. So the pollen grains which are formed in the male part of a plant, their transfer is needed so that it can reach to the female part of flower and fertilization occur. So in this, some agents are needed. So first agent of cross pollination is insects, and when insects helps in pollination, this is called as insect pollination. And two agents are insects which are involved in this transfer are butterflies and bees. Insect pollination has certain characteristics. Now see the characteristics of insect pollinated flowers. These flowers are large and they have a colored petals and scented to attract insects. The next is pollen is sticky or spiky to stick to insects' bodies. And the pollen grains which are produced in the male flower, they are spiky, means they have rough surface so that they easily stick on the body of insects. Stigma is sticky so that when insects brush past, the pollen sticks to it. The stigma means the female part of the flower, the broad part, that is the broad part, that is stigma. It is the broad part and it is sticky. So when insects sit upon it, the pollen grains stick to it. Sweet nectar is produced in the flower to attract insects. And stamens are inside the flower so that insects will brush past them and pick up pollen. Stamens are inside the flower. It means the stamens, they are covered with the colored petals so that it will not be easily blown away with the help of wind, and insects do this transfer process. The next is wind pollination. Wind pollination means when wind is the agent of pollination is called wind pollination, and very common examples are maize, palm and pine. And some characteristics of wind pollinated plants are the plant, they are usually small and are dull colors. They generally have long anthers protruding out of the flower so that pollen grains may get blown off easily. It means students, the flower is small and they have dull petals as there is no need to attract insects. And the large number of very light pollen grains that will be carried by the wind. As you can see, pollen grains, they are protruding. They are protruding means they are longer in size and they came out of the flower petals. And no nectar is produced in this case, so no need to attract insects. They produce a large quantity of pollen, and pollen grains that are large, light, so that easily carried away by the wind. Large stamens dangle outside the flower to catch the wind which blows away the pollen. Large stamen means more number of stamen, means the male part of flower, they are hanging outside the flower, means they are protruding in structure and they are present outside the flower so that they can be easily blown away by the wind. And the stigma, feathery stigmas hang outside the flower so that pollen can be trapped on them. And you can see stigma, that is feathery, and it is hanged outside the flower so that it can be easily trap the pollens. Next is water pollination. That is also called as hydrophily, and it is the mode of pollination or the transfer of pollen grains through the agency of water. Means when water is act as an agent for the transfer of pollen grains, that is called as water pollination, and water pollination is also called as hydrophily. And examples are Zostera vaccinaria. Some characteristics of the wind water pollination plants: flowers are small and inconspicuous. Flowers are small and light, so that easily they can float on water. Male nectar and odor are absent. Pollen grains are light and unwettable due to presence of mucilage cover. Pollen grains are light so that they can easily float on water surface, and they are unwettable means they cannot become wet. Pollen grains are produced in large numbers and the stigma is long, sticky but unwettable. And stigma is also long, sticky and unwettable, and it is present on the surface of water. And male part, that is the male flower, that is slightly below the water surface. In this picture you can see how the transfer of pollen grains in water occur. You can see here, this is male part, means pollen grains are produced in the male flower, and when they become mature, the pollen grains are remain floating on the surface of water. The pollen grains are released from the male part and they came over the surface of water. And this is female plant, means the plant which has the female part of the flower, and this female part, that is stigma, is present on the surface of water. And when this pollen grains, they remain floating on the surface of water due to the feathery and sticky stigma, it is stick over the stigma. The pollen grains that stick over the stigma, and further fertilization process occurs. This same process occurs in all the water plants for the pollination process. For more detail, just go through your textbook. Now today's homework, define pollination. Question number 2. Differentiate between self-pollination and cross-pollination with the help of diagram. In this question, you need to draw the diagrams of self-pollination and cross-pollination, both. Third question, explain different agents of cross-pollination with their characteristics. Write these answers in your biology notebook. Thank you.